Today, I will be explaining to you guys on how to make use of proxy on your account. So, because whenever I want to create any Fiverr account or, you know, any freelancing account, and I want to manage two accounts together, so I have to make use of proxy. So I don't make use of VPN on my PC anymore. I make use of proxy. So today I'll be explaining to you on how to make use of different proxy for your browsers. Whenever you want to create an account on Fiverr, you don't want them to block your accounts, or probably you want to, you know, create other accounts. Probably you want to create, you're a freelancer, you want to create Etsy account, Amazon account for your buyers, and you want them to be active. You don't want them to, you know, get restriction, and you want them to have be in a location whereby they won't be suspected. So you have to make use of proxy, because proxy is more secure than VPN when you are making use of VPN. Because if you are making use of VPN to create a Fiverr account, especially WinScribe, there is no way Fiverr will not, you know, notice your account creation on the same PC, and which will cause them to, you know, bring up the verification option. But since I've been using proxy on my accounts, either I create a foreign account or my local country accounts, I definitely do not get verification option. But when you start using either WinScribe or other VPN, you start to get, you know, for your first order, you start to get verification option on your account. So dive with me as I explain on how to, you know, make use of proxy on your browser for you to be able to manage your account easily when you are when you want to operate any of your freelancing accounts. So welcome back to my YouTube channel, David Rick. So now, the name of the proxy I use mostly is Dichvosocks. So I use Dichvosocks, I use Shopsocks 5. So these are the two platforms I use mostly. Now, Dichvosocks earlier was, you know, frustrating me. I was, you know, whenever I want to make use of proxy on my account, I have to, you know, copy and paste. The first thing you have to do is sign up with Dichvosocks.net. So now, immediately you sign up with Dichvosocks.net, first thing first, you have to buy socks, because this is not a free platform for you to get proxy. It's not a free platform, so you can use as little as $1 to $8 to, you know, as much as you can afford to get your proxy. So now these are the different plan options. You can see that when I go on to my buy socks option, you can see that it said I'm on a plan currently on a 50 daily proxy plan. So which means this Dichvosocks give me 50 proxy every single day. So whenever I use up the 50 proxy, so I have to wait for another day for me to be able to use another proxy. So, and that will be occurring the same day for the next 30 days until my 30 days plan expires. So because that's the plan I choose. So now for you to be able to check, subscribe to their plan, first of all, you have to check, you can go over to their home page. So immediately you go over to their home page, on their daily plan, you can see that their daily plan has 50 50, then 100 100, 200 200, 400 400, 600 600. Now what are these 100 50 200 stuff? These are the 50, which means they are going to be giving you 50 proxy daily, and as well they are going to be giving you daily 100 proxy. Now what are the prices for this proxy? So for the 50 daily proxy, you have to pay $8. Now it doesn't mean that you have to pay the $8 every single day, which means it will expire after 30 days. So which means for the next 30 days you'll be given 50 proxy daily for the next 30 days for just $8. And if you are not having up to $8, you probably have just $5, then you are going to activate the 15 days plan. So which means you are going to be given 50 daily proxy for the next 15 days. So every single day you get your 50 daily proxy. So, and also you can go for the $13 plan, and which they will be giving you 100 proxy per day for the next 30 days. Or probably you can go for the $7 plan, which they will be giving you 100 proxy for the next 15 days, based on how you want to use it. And if you have the money, you can subscribe for a year plan, which is the 100 proxy per day for a year, which is 1 year plan for $143. Or probably if you want to use for more than if you want to get 50 proxy daily, you can get $88 plan. So that is about their plan. And once you are ready to, you know, purchase, you have to go over to buy socks. Now the means of it for you to, you know, buy this plan is making use of crypto to purchase this plan. So you have to use crypto options to purchase this this plan. So on my next video, probably you don't know how to do this, I'll show you on how to, you know, fund this your account with your crypto balance. Probably use Bybit or Binance. So probably I will make use of Bybit, because I think Bybit is still very rampant for people to use. You can buy from P2P trade and fund your account with it. So once you are ready to fund your account, you can see that I'm on a, as I explained earlier, I'm on a 50 daily plan, which is the $8 a month that I subscribe to. So now you can see that now anytime you want to choose the plan, it will have all the plan option here. So well, because I'm on a plan already, I can't buy another plan except I want to upgrade. So now let's take for example that I want to buy the daily 50 option. So I have to select payment. So I have to choose the payment means I want to use. So I don't always use USD TRC20 because of the charges. I think they have an extra charge of $1.6. That's their own gas fee. So I make use of Litecoin often because they don't have any gas fee or any charges they put on whenever you want to fund the account on Bybit. So once you click on, you know, Litecoin, immediately click on Litecoin, it will ask you this and you click on OK. So immediately you click on OK, you see the option whereby they will ask you to, you know, scan the QR code for you to be able to get your wallet address, or probably you copy the wallet address directly, and you'll be given a timer, 1 hour plus, for you to be able to fund the account. And immediately you fund you pay the amount of money needed, which is $8, then this will be funded. And immediately it's funded, a message will pop up on the screen that your account is funded. And once you are done with that, you go over to Socks list. So once you do that, you go over to Socks list. And immediately go at Socks list, you can see that there will be available proxy for you, any country you want to choose. So there are a lot of countries. You can see all country, 10,371 countries are available for you to use. So proxy based on their location and, you know, region are available for you to use. So there are a lot of countries for you to use. So based on the country you want to, you know, probably want to use United States, Australia, you know. Different countries are available. So and once you want to choose one, so previously I always make use of an extension called Switch Omega to enter this proxy. So but recently but the disadvantage is that whenever the proxy expires, I have to, you know, come again to come and copy another proxy. So it always takes time and consume time. So but recently I found out that I can be able to, you know, make use of this Dichvosocks proxy easily on my account using the soft client option. So now when you go back to soft client option and you read this, when you said only support Microsoft operation system Windows 10 or higher, so which means you must have a Windows 10 PC and above for you to be able to perform this action. And account that you saw paid daily plan or credits, so which means only account that has a plan that is on a daily plan, or probably has a plan that you subscribe to a plan already, is liable to do this. And you have to do the Windows activation. So now these are the port option that is given to us, because you are going to do it manually, two option. So it's not manually because this is an automatic option for you to use, for you to set it up. So this is the way you are going to set it up. Now these options are what you are going to, so which means if you have different browser you want to, you know, you want to use in hosting different browser, you want to put the Dichvosocks proxy on at the same time. So these are the port number you have to use, the host name and port code you want to use. So you can, this is up to 10, so which means if you have up to 10 people, you can make use of this one account. And if you are more than 10, which means you have to, you know, probably create another account and subscribe to it, and another 10 people can use it as well. So now what do you have to do? Now the first thing you have to do is download the software, and once you download the software, once you click on download software, it will lead you to this window where it will ask you to download the Dichvosocks client zip file. So once you click on once you put your cursor on this, on the download option, you see standard download. You click on standard download. Then you click on standard download, you'll see the option whereby it is downloading the file. But sometimes it do says your antivirus do block it, because of your PC antivirus do block it, because it only suspects probably it might have virus. But this file doesn't have a virus. So one thing you have to do is off your Windows security, your Windows. So you can see that I turned my own off so that I can be able to use this software easily. So immediately you are done with downloading. So on your PC, it will ask you to extract the file. So immediately I extract the file, it will give me two options of this. So I'm going to launch this Socks 5 client option. Immediately I launch this Socks 5 client option, it will load up. It won't bring you to this phase directly. It will ask you to log in. And what are you going to use to log in? You are going to use the login details of your Dichvosocks. That login details you use in creating your Dichvosocks account will be the one you use in logging in this software you've downloaded. And immediately you log in, this is the window you are going to see. This is the next window you are going to see. So now immediately you see this window. Now you have to go back to your browser, the browser you want to use. So let me use one of these, my browser, as an example. So let's take, for example, we want to use this browser. We've downloaded the option, we've logged in the account on this, on the software. The software, we've logged in our account on the software, on Dichvosocks software already. And now we are asked to download an extension called foxyproxy. We have to download an extension called foxyproxy. So this is the extension. So we have to add this to Chrome. So immediately we add it to Chrome, you say, okay, add extension. And I'm going to pin it. Immediately it's downloaded, I'll pin it to my taskbar. So now, first thing it will ask us to do is, this is the option, this is what it will bring onto your window. Immediately you download this, once you click on the foxy proxy. So you head down to the option of, to this place called option. Immediately you click on the option, you go on to, you can see, on here you can see options, proxies, imports, pattern, tester. So you click on proxy. So now on this proxy, you see that it's empty. You are going to click on add. Now I have to name it. Let me name it based on my channel, The Heroic. So we are going to change this type to Socks 5 because we are using a Socks 5 proxy. Now it asks us for the host name and port number. So now this is our host name and port number. You are going to head over back to your Dichvosocks accounts. So do you see this Socks 5 ports option? So you have to click this. This is the first one, 127.006001. That is the first option. So this is what we are going to do. So if you have another browser you want to use on, you can copy this next one, which is 127.0.0. So that is 6002. That is the port number for the second option you want to use. Probably you want to use for another browser. So we are using this one for the first browser. I've used like 1, 2, 3 for another browser already, so but I've not made use of this first one and the rest. So if I have a lot of browser on my PC, then I can use all this port number on my PC to be able to, you know, use the proxy on all my browser easily. So now I'll head over back to my foxy proxy. So here I'm gonna paste the host name. So now the host name is just the 127.0.0.1. So I'm gonna remove this 6001. I'll cut it. I'll clear the column option and I'll paste that 6001 to the port option because that's the port number. So now I'm gonna click on save. So immediately I click on save, if I click on this thing, you can see that this is available now. So which means I will now go back to, now before I now go back to my software that I downloaded already. So now on this browser, you can see that this is my for you to check the location of your browser. So let me, this is my current location because I'm in Nigeria, so it will bring up Nigerian location. So because I've not turned on the proxy yet, so this will be bring my first location, my initial location. This will pop up. So anytime you want to check your location, you can go over to war.net to check your location. So immediately it's pop up. So let's await it and see the current location so that you can see how the location changes automatically itself without, you know, pasting any port number here and there. So as that goes on, so now don't forget to, you know, once you want to download the software, make sure you turn off your software, your Windows security software, so that you can be able to download this software, because it won't allow you to download with your PC security. So let's wait. I think the network is a bit slow, so let's wait for it to still load. So because I want it to bring the location that it's on presently, you can see that this is Nigerian location. You can see the flag. This is Ibadan, Nigeria. So now I'll put on this proxy now. I'll switch it on. So you can see that it's switched on. You can see this. So that shows that it's switched on. If I refresh now, it won't bring, it will looks like it's an empty, there's no network, but there's network on my PC is because I've not put a location to the port number there. So I'll go over to my software, back to my software. So now I'll choose the country I want to put my software in. Probably I want to be in the United States. So we click on United States. Immediately click on United States. On the blacklist option, click on no. Pick no. If you probably want to choose a region in your United States location, you can just choose the region you want, probably. So, but currently I don't want to choose any region, so I just want to put the United States only. So if you want to choose different region, you can see that there are a lot of regions in the United States. So now I will just click on search socks. So you can just switch one of these on based on the region you want to use. Probably I want to go on Texas. I will switch on the Texas, and it will ask me that view and forward to port 6001. You can see that this 6001 is the one I copied earlier on that browser. So which means this is going to forward it to the port number 6001, and my port number will be having that browser I use the 6001 on will be having this location on it. So immediately it so shows the IP. It says socks is offline. So immediately it says socks is off, socks 5 is offline. Go to another one. So let me switch another one on. Socks is offline as well. So let me click on search again so that I can see the ones that are online. So let me go for the California region as well. So now this is an IP given to us for the United States. Now let's go over back to our software, our browser. So if I refresh now, you can see that it has refreshed automatically itself. So you can see that the country will change automatically. So, and you can see that there is network on the browser, and you can see that it is loading because we've ported the United States IP, the proxy, to this port number 6001, and it's now working on the browser. So if it loads up now, you can see that the country will change to United States automatically. So this is how you are going to use your Dichvosocks account. And also another site I would recommend apart from Dichvosocks is this socks shop, socks 5. So you're going to do the same thing, the same way you funded your Dichvosocks is the same way you are going to fund this account as well. So they have a different plan option as well, the different pricing plan as well. So they have the socks 5 list. You can see the pricing plan for the socks 5 list on their own hand. So let's allow it to load. So now you can see that this is in the United States already. You can see the region United States, and if you come down here, you can see that the region is California based on what we choose in that particular place. You can see the IP. So if you go back to the software, you can see the IP on the software. So let's go back to the software. You can see that on the software we have 75. You can see that we have, hold on, I think my PC is okay. You can see that we have 75113 on the same thing on this as well. 75113188898. Same way we have it on here as well. So you can see that we have the same IP, and this browser is now working perfectly, and this is how I use proxy on my account. So anytime this proxy expires, the only thing you have to do is come to this software and switch, pick another one and port it. For example, maybe that one has expired, I'll just view another one and forward it to the CISO1. I'll just click on forward it to CISO1. So immediately I forward it to CISO1, you can see that if I refresh that browser, you can see that it will have this particular location as well, which is, it says unknown presently. So let's just await it to load. So let's see if socks is offline or online at this end.